Well, hello, everyone. I have to say it's new for me to be on a stage in New York City. New York City holds a special place for me because I've been in high school and college here. And it's good to be back from being remote to actually present in front of people. Anyway, so financial industry, do you know any other industries that is even more regulated? Probably there is some, but not many. Compliance is one of the key elements of being in financial industry, I guess after money. And it's kind of strange. So on one side, we're talking here about open source, we're talking about Linux, collaboration, community, and it's so, so far away from being regulated. It's so, it kind of doesn't care about that part. You have developers who do it for fun. You have people who are solving their own itch. But on the other hand, you have to deal with PCI, you have to deal with SOC 2, you have to deal with Sarbanes-Oxley Act. You have all those regulations. And one thing over the years that is becoming more and more apparent that fines for breaking those regulations, for not being compliant, are going up. And I mean, Sarbanes-Oxley, I believe it's $1 million per incident. GDPR is up to 20 million euro or 4%. And California Data Privacy Act is $750 per person with no cap, so 100,000 users. A lot of money. Anyway, so that's not the only thing that is changing about compliance. It's not only the cost of being not compliant going up. What's changing that is from security perspective, you are expected to patch things faster. You're expected to make sure that everything is secured at higher and higher rate. So when we started, well, not that we started, but around 2000, the typical patch window for vulnerabilities was around 6 months. Then it went to 3 months. Lately, it is 1 month. And the window is shrinking. So 1 month, is it going to stay? Are we going to switch to 1 week? Is it going to be as soon as possible? What is as soon as possible? 24 hours? I don't know. So there is the reasons why it's happening. Probably number one reason is not even data privacy. Number one reason today is ransomware. So after Colonial Pipeline ransomware attack, and that industry is getting regulated probably more than financial industry today. They're actually talking about 1 week for applying the patches. So pipeline industry is gearing up today to deal with 1 week. And I can promise you that if they can deliver it, you will have to deliver it next, maybe not now, maybe in 5 years, but that's where it will be. On the other hand, the data privacy laws are forcing people to be more diligent about compliance, so the fines are extremely high. And the way they're triggered is that, hey, data isn't exfiltrated, but you also have to be not compliant. So if you just lose your data because who knows what, you're fine. If you lose your data and you haven't patched in time, you actually have to pay. So there is a lot of reasons to patch simply because those fines will be activated if you don't. And the number of CVEs discovered per year is growing, so you really don't need a data lake and data analytical tools to see that this year is going to be more than the last year. And without a crystal ball, I can promise you that in 2022, there is going to be more CVEs. In 2023, there is going to be even more CVEs discovered. I don't know how long the trend will continue, but there is definite trend, and we'll see more and more of those things happening. So, why people get infected? What's the root cause for malware being on your system? The root cause is still being unpatched. So if you patch your system within few days of vulnerability being discovered, your chances of being infected drops by 99.8%. That doesn't come from us, that actually comes from Palo Alto Networks. It's one of the data points that they've seen among their customers. So patch soon, patch often, but majority of people don't patch often. They don't patch in time. 60% of companies don't patch within 5 weeks. And that's pretty bad. So what happens is that even if you are compliant within 30 days, there is a huge, huge window of opportunity for the hackers, even within those 30 days. The more you are out of patch, the bigger problem it is. So for majority of CVEs that are gonna get exploited, the hackers start to exploit them within first week of the CVE being announced. So as long as as soon as vulnerability gets published, within a week you can expect it to be exploited. There is 0 days, there is nothing you can do about 0 days vulnerability from that perspective. But still, the sooner you can get patches out, the sooner your system is protected, the more chances are that you will not have to deal with the regulators and prove that you're compliant. Anyway, so why people don't patch in time? I mean, it makes sense to patch, but why don't they patch in time? And the problem is that patching causes downtime. There is many reasons why, but if you need to update Linux kernel or you need to update SSL library, glibc library, you will have to deal with the downtime. You will have to work within your maintenance window. You will have to schedule it with your departments, across departments, and it's all creates problems. And sometimes you miss it because, hey, it doesn't work. Something has changed, ABI, API. Things change and break, and you have to wait for the next window. So that's actually the problem we're solving with live patching. We have a product called Kernel Care. We can live patch Linux kernel. We can live patch glibc. We can live patch OpenSSL. We can live patch MySQL. And there is a lot of benefits behind it. First of all, it's less work for your team. Patches can be updated with no downtime, with no packet loss, with no interruptions. It can be done in staged rollout way, following your best practices for CI/CD today. So we solve this problem for large fleets of servers, and we solve it extremely efficiently. Your window is shrunk to just a few days. Some people still use monthly windows to apply live patching. They just don't have to schedule the downtime. But the idea is that you can keep the window to the minimum. You can be patched within days. That's what we do. That's our core business. We also provide extended lifecycle support for out-of-date Linux distributions like CentOS 6, Red Hat 6, Ubuntu 16. And we do it well. Thank you very much.